Hi, I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. In this short video, I'm going to go through how to manage duplicate contacts in Mailchimp and more importantly, what a duplicate contact is. Let's go across to Mailchimp. I'm in Mailchimp. The first thing to know is that duplicates are considered from a Mailchimp perspective as the same email address in a single audience. So these are my audiences, and let me explain. I'll go into this audience, for example. And what you'll notice is that the email address is unique. I cannot have the same email address more than once in an audience. Mailchimp just won't let me add the same email address more than once. I can have the same details in other fields, but the email address has to be unique. Let me explain a little bit further, and what we'll do is we'll import this spreadsheet. What we can see is that Yashin, for example, has the same first name, last name, two Yashin Singhs. However, the email addresses are different. Thus, Mailchimp considers them different contacts, and Mailchimp will add both of these people. However, this person, Gary and Gazza, they share the same email address. Thus, Mailchimp will only add Gary or Gazza once. And I'll explain the order this how it actually works. So if I copy the information from this Google sheet, it could be Excel as well, I'll go back into Mailchimp. So if I want to import into this audience, and I'm not going to go through the whole import process, I'll just show you how to manage these duplicate contacts. I'll click continue. I'll just paste in my data very quickly to get to the next screen. And what we'll notice once we get to the next screen is the audience we've selected. But this here, this update any existing contacts, that option is really important. How Mailchimp works, going back to our spreadsheet, is when we're importing, it starts at the top. It starts at the first line or the first contact, and it works the way down. So going back to Mailchimp, and I'm sorry, I'm going backwards and forwards a little bit. If I do not click this update any existing contacts, in this case, in the case of Gary here, it would add this one, Gary, because it starts at the top and goes down. It'll add Gary into my audience. By the time it gets to this entry, it'll say, hold on, that person's already in my audience. I can't add the same email address twice. Therefore, I'm just going to not update my audience and just leave that one in. However, if I click this update any existing contacts, Mailchimp will add that entry there, the Gazza. And it's the same if you're using, sorry, going backwards and forwards, but if you're using this update any existing contacts and a person is or an email address is already in your audience and you have that person on the spreadsheet, if that's checked, it'll add the details for that email address from the spreadsheet. However, if it's not, it'll just not update with the details for that specific person or email address from the spreadsheet. And just remembering that this is done at the audience level again. So for each individual audience, you can have the email address only once. But what happens if you consider a duplicate in another way? So for example, let's say we consider this as a duplicate. Even though Mailchimp doesn't, because the email address is different. But if we have two Gary Ecksteins, my name, and we want to get rid of one out of our audience, the best way of doing that is select the one you want to remove. Just click to the left-hand side of the screen, and you might need to be on quite a wide screen to see these checkboxes to the left-hand side. Then merely click Actions and Archive. By archiving, you won't see that person, that email address in your audience any longer, and you won't be paying for them in Mailchimp. But please subscribe to my channel. Please like this video. I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au.